So, answer of this question is annual revenue saved per kilometer equal to 21,648 rs. Okay. So saving in maintenance also we can calculate. Saving in maintenance, that is the annual maintenance cost of unlined channel for 10 square per meter is given. That is 1 rupees. That is 1 rupees annual maintenance cost. Okay. So total perimeter, total area of total weighted perimeter per kilometer length is calculated. That is 18,800. A square meter. Okay, so if total maintenance is 1 rupees and area is itna, so total maintenance cost equal to 18,800 rupees. Okay, 18,800 itna rupees. Okay, per kilometer. And also we assume that 40% of this is saved in line channel. So if 40% is saved in line channel, then the total maintenance charge is 0.4 into 1880. That is total saving cost is 752 rupees. Okay, so total annual benefit per kilometer we can calculate 744 इतना प्लस 752 दैट इज 22,400 रुपीज. दिस इज द टोटल सेविंग कॉस्ट. ओके, टोटल सेविंग कॉस्ट. सो बाय दिस मेथड वी कैन ऑल्सो कैलकुलेट एंड ऑल्सो जस्टिफाई द एनुअल बेनिफिट कॉस्ट रेशियो फॉर द कैनाल लाइनिंग. So one more portion is remaining in canal lining, that is the velocity, what is the permissible velocity, and also what is the thickness suggested as per IS code thickness of canal, cement concrete canal lining for irrigation canal. Okay, so thickness of cement concrete lining. So a thickness of about 5 to 15 centimeter of cement concrete is generally used for larger canal, and that depend upon the canal capacity. That thickness is provided as per canal capacity. The nature of canal and the special requirements of imperviousness and the structural strength also that resist cracking or not, and also on slight movement of subgrade. These all factor on these all factor depends the thickness of the line. Okay, so minimum thickness is used in canal lining is 7.5 centimeter. So minimum thickness used in India, that is 7.5 centimeter in India. Okay, and if a stable slope of order of 1.5:1 or 1/1:4:1 is adopted, and also for a steeper slope is also required more thickness. If a slope is steeper, then in that condition thickness of line portion is thickness of lining is required more. Okay, but if thickness is more, so that is uneconomical. So we have to design this type of channel or canal on that type. Its slope should be 1:1:1 वन और 1:1:4:1. ओके, सो द लेवल एंड ड्रेज सबग्रेड सॉइल सरफेस shall be moisturized thoroughly before the laying cement concrete so that the moisture is not withdrawn by the subgrade from the cement concrete lined surface. And in case of inverted filter is laid over the subgrade to take care of the differential hydrostatic pressure material. Layer is immediate contact with CC cement concrete lining and to make such filter blanket effective and to prevent ingress of concrete into it. Okay, so a tar paper is also provided, also placed over the filter blanket before the placing cement concrete. Okay, so before the cement concrete lining, a tar paper is also placed over the filter blanket. Okay, so concrete lining is also done by either hand placing or mechanical placing. So hand placing of cement concrete is usually adopted in India, particularly for the smaller canal section, and if larger canal section, then mechanical placing process is used for cement concrete lining. Okay, so cement concrete shall be dumped and sprayed on the bed of the side slope of the canal as usually in panel of not or more than 3 meter side with suitable joint in between. Okay, so in between suitable joint is also provided, and the construction joint so formed it will serve the purpose of contraction joint, which are basically required for shrinkage of concrete and also take care of temperature stresses cause the change of temperature. So if cement concrete is provided, cement concrete lining is provided, then two method is picked, either hand or mechanical. So for a small canal, hand picking is provided for large canal. Okay. Panel bed is not more than 3 meter side. Contraction joint is also provided. Okay, so also sleeper shall be 20 centimeter wide. Sleeper should be 20 centimeter wide and 10 centimeter deep. 10 centimeter deep for canal with capacity less than 15 cubics. Capacity less than 50 cubics. Okay, and the sleeper shall be also placed centrally below the joint. Okay, and the cement concrete lining used for sleeper shall be the same grade as for lining. Okay, and mechanical vibration of cement concrete is always preferred for the compaction, and also screed vibrator is also used for compaction. So hand placing is done by this process, hand placing of cement concrete lining. So mechanical placing is also done for cement concrete lining, and usually it is adopted for large size project or large size canal which is generally used or projected in developed country. Okay, by using sleeve form machines. So by mechanical method, machine is used sleeve form. Okay, sleeve form machine is used, and that is supported on rail placed along the both front of canal, means both side of canal is sleeve machine is moved and concrete is placed at the surface of the canal. ओके सो कॉन्क्रीट फॉर स्लिप फॉर्म शुड बी एयर इंट्रेंट एंड ऑल्सो एज टू प्रोवाइड अ मोर वर्केबल एंड स्लीपेबल मिक्स. ओके सो बाय स्लिप मशीन कॉन्क्रीट सीमेंट कॉन्क्रीट मिक्सर इज मोर वर्केबल एंड मोर स्लीपेबल मिक्सर प्रिपेयर्ड. ओके एंड द परसेंटेज ऑफ एयर रिकमेंडेड एज पर IS कोड. सो जनरली परसेंटेज ऑफ एयर वॉल्यूम एंड मैक्सिमम एग्रीगेट साइजेस गिवन बाय IS कोड इज साइज ऑफ एग्रीगेट एंड हेयर परसेंटेज एयर कंटेंट बाय वॉल्यूम. सो इफ एग्रीगेट साइज इन mm इज 10 mm देन परसेंटेज एयर बॉडी 8%. इफ कॉन्क्रीट साइज इज 12.5 देन परसेंटेज एयर कंटेंट इज 7%. इफ एग्रीगेट साइज इज 20% देन एयर कंटेंट इज 6%. इफ कॉन्क्रीट साइज इज मोर देन 20 दैट इज इफ 25 cm देन एयर कंटेंट इज 5%. इफ कॉन्क्रीट साइज इज 40 mm देन एयर कंटेंट इज 4.5%. ओके सो दिस टेबल इज गिवन एज पर IS 10430. सो फॉर लाइनिंग अ स्मॉल टू मॉडरेट साइज ऑफ कैनाल सबग्रिड्स गाइडेड स्लिप फॉर्म आर यूज्ड एंड इफ स्लिप फॉर्म इज सपोर्टेड डायरेक्टली ऑन द सबग्रिड एंड ऑपरेटेड लॉन्गिट्यूडनली अलोंग इट then concrete is created on the width along the canal length and as well as size from the bottom of the top. Okay, and for large canal is considerable length. Large canal for considerable length, rail guided slip form is used. Okay, for large canal, rail guided slip form are used and slip form is supported on rail placed along the both worm of the canal and are operated longitudinally and or the side slope from bottom to top. Okay. So for hand placing with the light machine and concrete is skidded or splitted from the bottom to top of the side slope and the consistency of concrete should be such that it will be nearly stay on the slope and the workability test or the slump size is 60 to 70 mm. Okay, for hand placing workability is 60 to 70 mm. This point is very useful for hand placing workability or slump size is 60 to 70 mm. For which purpose? For cement concrete lining of canal. And for heavy longitudinal operating slip form machine, the slump size should be 50 mm. So for machine hand pick, for machine pick. For machine placing, slump size will be 50 mm. Slump size should be 50 mm. Okay. And it should be close control on the consistency as well as workability of concrete. Okay. And the slump should not be vary more than 20 mm. Should not be vary more than 20 mm. Variation should not be more than 20 mm. And otherwise, there will be an interference with the progress and the quality of the work. So, check the slump at the time of placing of the cement concrete in lining. Okay. And how finishing the cement concrete lining? So the surface of concrete finishing against form shall be smooth and free from the any projection. projection, honeycombing, and other objects nibble if defect. Okay, so concrete lining should be free from honeycombing as well as any objects nibble defect. And immediately on removal of forms, all unsightly rays or lips shall be removed also, and undesirable local bulging on exposed surface shall be also remedied by tooling and rubbing the surface. Okay, so no any bulging or on exposing surface should be occurred. Okay, if any bulging is occurred, then it is removed by any mechanical tool or rubbing the surface. Okay, and repair to concrete surface and additional where the requirement shall be made by cutting regular or opening into the concrete and placing the fresh concrete to the required line. Okay, if any opening is present, then fresh concrete is filled up in that opening, and the chipped opening shall be stopped and shall not be less than 70 mm in depth. Okay, so chipped opening should be sharp and shall not be less than 70 mm in depth. And also the fresh concrete shall be reinforced and chipped and trolled to the surface of the opening. The mortar shall be also placed in the layer and not more than 20 mm in thickness. Okay, after the being compacted. So mortar thickness is provided 20 mm after the compacted each layer. After the compacted each layer, mortar thickness should be 20 mm. Okay, as per IS 10430. So all exposed concrete surface shall be cleaned from the impurities, lumps of mortar, and also any type of grout or unsightly stain. So that surface is considered finished. Okay, well finished surface. Now the last process is the curing of cement concrete lined surface. So how it is cured? So as per laying concrete lining, and after a period of 24 to 36 hours, the lining should be cured at least 28 days. So lining should be cured at least 28 days. So lining should be cured for 28 days. Okay. So on bed, this may be done by constructing 150 mm deep earthen one across the bed, or a small depth of water will also regularly stand on the bed. Okay. And the curing of the side slope also may be done by constructing machinery train with holes or perforated pipe on the coping at the top of the lining, or also by done by sprinkling. So either made earthen or earthen bund on the bed or for side slope, a sprinkler is used. For side slope, a sprinkler is used for curing purposes. Okay. Next and last process for the cement concrete lining is surface drainage. So how it is done? So currently with the curing operation, surface drainage arrangement of the bank, such as construction of dovels, bank surface slope away from the lining, and construction of the longitudinal drain on the outer face shall be completed. And this is also necessary to prevent surface and subgrade erosion and consequent damage to the lining. So drainage should be provided as per requirement. Okay. Joints in the cement concrete lining, that is joints in cement concrete lining, crack in CC, that is crack in cement concrete lining, usually occur due to either warping stress. Okay, and also due to tensile stress. Okay, so what is warping stress and why it is occurs? So warping stress caused due to difference in temperature between the atmosphere and concrete lining, or either due to moisture potential between the two faces of the cement concrete slab. So warping stress is developed due to why? Either temperature difference. Due to temperature difference or moisture difference. Okay. And tensile stress, why tensile stress is developed? So tensile stress is developed due to differential temperature variation between the upper and lower face of the cement concrete. Warping stress is due to temperature difference between surface and atmosphere, but tensile stress is developed due to upper and lower layer difference. Temperature of upper and lower layer. Upper and lower layer. Okay. So for prevention of these stresses, we have to provide joints. So there are various types of joint is provided in cement concrete lining. First joint is expansion joint. Second joint is construction joint. Third is contraction joint. So where it is generally provided? So expansion joint is generally usually not provided in cement concrete lining except where a structure intersect the canal. If a structure intersect the canal, then expansion joint is provided, but usually it is not provided. And at the intersecting structure, an expansion joint of 25 mm width. Expansion joint of 25 mm width filled with sealing compound is provided. In which condition it is provided? If a structure intersects the canal, in that condition expansion joint is provided of 25 mm width. Okay, and filled with sealing compound. Okay, next joint is the construction joint. So construction joint, which are left during casting of cement concrete lining, as pointed out earlier, or do serve the purpose of contraction joint, and which are specifically required to take care of shrinkage and temperature stresses. So generally necessary for cement concrete lining for the purpose of prevention of temperature differential stresses, warping stresses. Okay, and it will be also provided at where it is provided. So it is provided left due to difficulty in laying the cement concrete of the stress, and also construction joint left intentionally for the making provision for the shrinkage and temperature stresses. So generally provided in the in that condition where stresses occurs due to temperature differences. So this is the layer of cement concrete lining. This is the layer of cement concrete lining. Here is provide this is the cement concrete bed sleeper. Okay, this is the cement concrete lining. This is the cement concrete lining. And here this is the faces to paint it with ceiling compound. This is the faces. This is the ceiling compound. Filled with ceiling compound. And this is the primer at the rate of 4 meter square. Primer. Okay. So two layer of ceiling compound is provided. First layer is at 1 liter per 2 meter square and second layer is at 1 liter per 4 meter square as per given in cement concrete lining code, that is IS. That is given IS 3873-1978. Okay, this is the IS code for cement concrete lining. This is the IS code for cement concrete lining. We can also show the diagram for detailed expansion joint, contraction joint. Okay. So that we can also show here. Okay, so for this type of joint, contraction joint and expansion joint, reinforcement should be provided 0.25 to 0.3% of concrete. So reinforcement should be provided in joint of cement concrete lining. Reinforcement should be provided 0.25 meter to 0.3%. Okay. And practically nothing to a structural strength of uncracked lining, but it has been also found the reinforcement reduce the width of shrinkage crack, and due to this reason reducing seepage and prevent possible floating of the crack slab. Okay, so generally in long slab, that is the 15 meter or more than 50 meter, the interval between the transverse crack was found to be more in unreinforced slab as compared to those in reinforced slab. Okay, So generally 0.25% of the cross section area of concrete reinforcement is provided, and that type of lining will be involved only in construction joint to be left after day's work from the longitudinal steel to be also taken continuously through this joint. Okay, so advantage of casting C2 cement concrete lining is the longer life. Okay, cement concrete lining should be longer life and as compared to other type of lining, and also least permeable of all type, most resistant to erosion, also permit fast construction by mechanical means, and also low recurring maintenance charge. Okay, and also some disadvantage of cement casting C2 cement concrete lining is the cost is very high. Okay, and also greater possibility of temperature cracking, less flexible and easily affected by adverse subgrade conditions. So in C2 cement concrete lining is also less flexible and easily affected by adverse subgrade condition, and also a skilled supervision and construction necessary. Okay, so these are the advantage and disadvantage of cement concrete lining. Okay, these are the advantage and disadvantage of cement concrete lining.